Secretary back on deck. What's going on, everybody? What's going on, Vinyl Community? Have some a few LPs that I just want to share with you guys real quick. Do some needle drops, as I always do. First of all, I want to give a shout out to the Facebook Vinyl Community Facebook. I think if you guys haven't looked into doing it yesterday, I kind of experienced a different experience. I've been on Facebook ever since you need a college email to be on it, and up until yesterday, I hadn't really experienced Facebook quite like this. The Vinyl Community on Facebook is vast, and it's just like it's the real time, what I like about it, it has enabled me to communicate with people that I haven't yet really communicated with just through the regular YouTube. For example, Dr. Deadwax. Him and I shared a couple of threads yesterday, man, just going back and forth, found out some similarities. I've watched his videos. Glowing Cabbage hit me up. But Glowing Cabbage, I never really articulated to him. But I have always liked Glowing Cabbage. Haven't really kicked it with him on YouTube like that, but, you know, he reached out to me on Facebook, man. It's just good to hear from these people. Who else? I think Lazarus, we were in the same thread. It was good to just be in the same form and talking about the same thing as these people. Chris Brzezinski, am I saying that right? Let me look it up so I'm not sounding like a fool. Presents the gentleman who's a farmer, Chris, communicated with him. Oh, man, King Crimp, you know, there's a lot of things that I haven't gotten to, like my rock section, my psych. Most of my rock is psych. I love psychedelic. I haven't been on here a year yet, but, you know, I haven't gotten to that. And, you know, I love one thing that I haven't articulated or let be known is that I am the biggest King Crimson fan in the world. Well, I'm sure there's larger. I'm just trying to let you know how much I like. I love anything King Crimson. And yesterday's thread just took off, man, but it wasn't even about the thread. Which, by the way, Pink Floyd is just real heavy in the vinyl community. But I just got to communicate with Dr. Deadwax, Chris. Lazarus was in their thread. Let me see. Let me just jog my memory, man. Because, he wasn't in the thread, I don't think. But also, I've been able to reach out and speak with Aaron because I didn't even know who Aaron was on Facebook. I saw the name, but I didn't know who he was on YouTube. It's a lot that's coming together that I like. So, if you see this video, and I haven't reached it, please, man, friend me. Let me know who you are. I want to know who you are. I want to know who my subscribers are, because I just do. I want to return the favor. I want to know each and every one of you. Derek seems really good. Teddy seems really good with just knowing folks, man. You know, I want to know folks. I want to know who you are. I want to communicate because I haven't gotten the chance to do that on the actual YouTube. It's just me uploading a video, you watching, you commenting, but it's different on Facebook. First things first, I want to shout out to BIGSTAR. Had the Alice Clark LP, and I told him I was going to show my OG. I got this actually for less than $1, and there's that that roulette distribution label thing that's on a lot of the 300 mainstream Red Lion series LPs. As you can see, BIGSTAR, yours is an exact reissue. Ain't nothing missing from it. It's perfect. And, you know, like I told him, I got this for less than $1 from this crazy guy named Herbert who came up to me one day when I was making this huge acquisition of brand new albums that just came in to a thrift store. And he was like, oh, you like albums? Went to his house after communicating with him, and man, that guy was crazy. First of all, he lived in an apartment, but it was like a three going up on one side, so it was six apartments. And he came to the apartment with about a samurai blade that was about that long, a little miniature one. And I'm like looking at this guy like, what the fuck, man? I mean, he was already weird. And when we were going up, we were on the going up to the third floor, and his neighbors under him opened the door, and they just start having words with each other. These young kids. going back and forth. What the fuck you looking at? Blah, blah, blah. And he's just losing mind and just snaps right out of it. Like, all right, come on. And I'm like, what the hell is that? Going to his house from floor to ceiling. Nothing but boxes piled up. This guy used to have his own flea market stand, he said, back in the 70s. And this stuff has been in his house ever since. A lot of it was beat to shit, but what I did come across was a box of this mainstream, the 300 series mainstream LPs. And this is what got me collecting this series, because I got like 70 of them all at one time, and it was crazy. And this was in one of them, and this was in mint condition. Like, look at that. So I wanted to show that to BIGSTAR. Shout out to BIGSTAR for getting that LP. There it is. That's how I came to get my OG Alice Clark. And like he said, it's just a phenomenal LP. This LP sets itself apart from all the other LPs that were issued on the 300 mainstream Lion series. I suggest, and I didn't know it was reissued. And now that I do know it's reissued, I'm going to really package this one up well and just kind of sit it on the shelf and listen to the reissue, because I do enjoy it. All right, so let's start some needle drops. Want to recommend an album to you guys. This came out in 2011. This is Mr. President. He's a bass player. This came out on Favorite Recordings. This is an absolute phenomenal funk LP. This is funk done the right way, y'all. I mean, this is just heavy, heavy, heavy as hell. So soulful, so well done. I don't know if you guys know, I don't know if you guys know the singer, what's his name? Mr. Day. Cat from the UK sings, soul singer. He's bad. He's doing most of the vocals on this. He has a bomb cover of Love and Happiness. Watch out, Hammer. So let me drop that on y'all. I'm going to just do a few needle drops and move on. Just enough so you guys can get the gist of how funky this is. Let's see. Oh, that's not what I wanted to play. This needle drop session starting all wrong already. I have to turn on this light up here. So that's some of the moving to the second song for you guys. And so if you want to see how hard hitting he is, I didn't know it took this long. It's funky, y'all. I do one more, or a couple more. Let's see. Oh, damn. So check out this. I mean, this, he's all over the place with the funk. Alright. sorry if I'm cutting this kind of short with the needle drops, but believe me, I'm making way for longer needle drops that you definitely are going to appreciate, like this one. This is an LP I've had for a while. This year, though, I think I got this back in January, February. This is Free the Robots, Control, Alt, Delete. This is like electronic music to me at its best. It's a double LP. And, I mean, this just synth out with heavy, heavy bass, 808 all through this, man. Like, this right here gets me excited. To me, almost, I would put this, you know, right behind this LP. This is a holy grail of mine. Put it right behind this one. Nightmares on Wax. In a Space Out of Sound. As far as me just wanting it and how I pursued it and the music that's on it, it's just off the hook. So this needle drop is probably going to be about a minute long. I just want you to hear the beginning of the song so you can understand the build up and just hear how hard-hitting this LP is. This is electronic music, so check it out. This is Orion's Belt Buckle, one of my favorite cuts on here. The label's pretty simple, nothing real special about the label. This is and then so the beat does drop. I didn't know it was this repetitive. I thought that it dropped a lot earlier than this, but just hold on. There it is. And then the random needle drop. So that's another one. So this next LP, strap in, because it's going to be where we're at, 13 minutes. We make a good time. We make a good time. See if I can make this 22-minute video. Go ahead, Ham. You go out there. Go ahead. All right, y'all. Super duper holy grail for me. It gets no better than this. You heard me talk about Daptone Records and how all of these fly-by-night funk bands are just saturating the market right now with their music, and it's just not as good. It's not well thought out. Well, I had a discussion with Blake when we went to dinner. I was telling him about this jazz label called Ricky Tick Records out of Finland. Oh, man, and they are doing it right. Let me tell you, man, the jazz is off the hook. And I'm going to do a post on my other Ricky Tick stuff that is jazz. But this right here is the hardest, the most expensive, the rarest album to find on Ricky Tick Records. And this is the Stance Brothers, Kind Soul. The Stance Brothers are two musicians, Isaiah and Dwayne. Isaiah plays the vibes, keyboards and percussions, but on this he's mainly heavy on the vibes. Oh my god, y'all, this is like in the forefront are the vibes as far as what's leading the jazz on this. This is jazz with definitely funk infused. They have a song on here called Roll Call, basically, which is a drum break hunter's dream. And B-Boys, hello, if you guys don't know about this LP, y'all, this is your LP. Drum break people, this is your LP. It's not going to be easy to find, but let me tell you something. Just the one song called Roll Call will make you wet your pants. And that's what I'm going to play for y'all, Roll Call. And what they're doing is they're shouting out every single badass jazz drummer. Roll call. Listen to the names.
Max Roach, Art Blakey, Kenny Clark, Roy Haynes, Sonny Payne, Sam Woodyard, Mel Lewis, Ed Blackwell, Billy Higgins, Elvin Jones, Tony Williams, Buddy Rich, Carl Burnett, Billy Joe, Jimmy Cobb, Joe Chambers, Ronell Fournier, Roger Humphreys, Al Foster, Grady Tate, Mickey Rocker, Joe Morello.
This is later on in the same song, Roll Call. They get jazzy with it and they start showing off. Man. Here's their tribute to Steve McQueen. We all know about Steve McQueen. If you don't look the name up, get the music. So here's their song. It's called Steve McQueen. And I'm just going to play the first. You know what? I'm going to have to fast forward this. That's the vibes. That's Isaiah's stance on the vibes. Okay, before I flip it over to the next side, let's do a random needle drop for you guys. All right, so it's one more song that I want you guys to hear. I believe it's called Jay's Lament, but there is a song on here. Upside the Head. Let me see if I can play that for you. Because at the end of one of these songs is a crazy ass drum break. Y'all can't dig that. What do you dig? Almost reminds you of a theme song to Taxi as far as. I mean. Let's get back to see if I can do a random one for you. Spending a lot of time on this one. Mm-hmm. my God, man. I got to play this after I finish. While this video is uploading, you damn right. I mean, I'm going to be playing this LP, man. Woo-wee! Oh, this next one, Ikendive. Not to be confused with the political conscious rapper, solo rapper Ikendive. This is a Latin jazz hip-hop outfit. And I use the term hip-hop very lightly. This album is done and co-produced by Nana Vasconcelos. Actually, all music is written by Nana Vasconcelos. And this shit right here is just unbelievably good. The jazz on here is unbelievably good. The rapping in Spanish on here is unbelievably good. This LP, Ikendive, it came out in 2011. This is on Ropadope Records. I'm going to do two needle drops on this for you guys. So you can hear what it is, man. This is just amazing, amazing LP. Let me make sure I'm doing a needle drop on the right side. Yeah. Just check this out. Y'all will dig this.
Inspiração, ação, espontâneo como transpiração. É algo necessário, é algo necessário.
Check out this chick, man.
Necessário, como sabe o que tem feito. Meio amate, lixo, excesso, imagem, áudio, imbecil. Quanto mais, mas esse belo falante débil. Tudo é dúbio, não
conhece
possível. Se a fazeres aos prazeres, sou fiel. Nada como captar, matismo, doce, entrelinha. Fazer suas meninas virar estrelinhas. Compra de coração, rosa, choque e apulsar tranquilamente na cadência. Enquanto passe, voar.
That's dope, but check out the jazz. That's the jazz on this LP is to die for, man. Let me see. I can find it, but right. I can't. This is a horrible glare. Horrible, horrible glare. Just let this ride out, man. There's no rapping in this song. They're chanting vocals in this song, but there's no rapping. This is the... This is Nana, man. Nana Vasconcelos. I love this LP. Nice. Yeah. I'm gonna just let this ride out. This is the end of the video, y'all. There's no more. I'm just gonna let this ride out.